phenotyping algorithm is very important in supporting genome-wide association study. What is a genome-wide association study? It's an approach that involves scanning biomarkers such as single nucleotide polymorphism, or SNPs, from DNA of many people in order to find genetic variation associated with a particular disease field phenotypes. Once new genetic associations are identified, researchers can use that information to develop better strategies to detect and treat and prevent diseases. So, how are genomic-wide association studies conducted? To run a genomic-wide association study, or GWAS, we first identify the disease phenotypes. Then group the participants into these two groups, cases, and these are people with disease phenotypes. And controls, those are similar patient without the disease phenotype. Then we need to obtain DNA samples from all these participants. From DNA samples, we can use lab machines to quickly survey each participant's genomes for genetic variation, which are called single nucleotide polymorphism or SNP. If certain genetic variation have found to be significantly more frequent in the people with the disease phenotypes compared to people without the disease phenotype, these variations are said to be associated with the disease. We do this by computing the frequencies of SNPs on the cases and on the controls. Then based on the frequency, we calculate the odds ratio. From there, we can calculate the corresponding p-value for the odds ratio. If the p-value is small, then we conclude this variation is significant. The associated genetic variations can serve as powerful pointers to the region of the human genome that may cause the disease. Here's an example showing more details on how the GWAS is computed. We first identified the cases and controls. That is, the people with the disease phenotype and the people without the disease phenotype. In this case, we have 4,000 patients with the disease phenotype and 6,000 patients without the disease phenotype. Then we iterate over all the SNPs to compare the relevant frequencies. For instance, for SNP 1 for the control group, we have 2,676 out of 6,000 has the corresponding variation G at this location. And the frequency of G in this case is 44.6%. In the case group, we have 2,104 out of 4,000 with the corresponding variation G at this location. So, the frequency is 52.6%. If we go through the calculation, we'll find now the p-value is 5 times 10 to the minus 15. Which means, this is extremely significant. We can conduct the same calculation on SNP 2 and find out the p-value here is 0.33, which is not significant. To support GWAS study, we need to know high-quality phenotypes on the cases and controls in order to perform this calculation. That's why phenotyping algorithm is very important. As we have shown in the genome-wide association studies, we need phenotypic data in order to analyze genomic data. But in general, why do we care about phenotyping algorithms in genomic study? In fact, many people argue that we need rich and deep phenotypic data in order to analyze genomic data. Especially as sequencing technology improves, the cost of generating genomic data is dropping so fast over time. While the cost of computing or Moore's law cannot keep up with the improvement of sequencing technology, which means we'll have more and more genomic data in near future about many individuals. However, due to the complexity of the electronic health record, the cost for generating high-quality phenotypic data is actually increasing, while the cost of genomic data is dropping drastically. That is why we really need to invent better phenotyping algorithms to reduce the cost of acquiring high-quality phenotypic data and to support genomic studies.